move on to lighter topics. Got a haircut today. There's largely in this country, I've realized there are two types of places you can go for a haircut. First is a fancy salon, right? It's the fancy place, you save up money, go to the fancy salon. The second place is the place where most of us, and me especially, have been for most of my life, which is the unisex salon. And it is called unisex, but you will never see any women there ever. Never. Once in a blue moon, one lady will walk in out of nowhere looking completely lost, like, what is this place? Oh my God. The smells of Gillette and compromise. What's happening? And when she walks in, along with her at the other side of the room, a northeastern lady appears out of nowhere. And she takes her by the hand, escorts her into a secret room where she disappears forever. Nobody knows what happens. I think what happens is that they take her down into that room, into a dungeon, where they sacrifice her to an idol of Shehnaz Hussain. I think this is what's happening. This is Shehnaz Hussain's fountain of eternal youth. I love out of 2,000, there are only 200 people who are middle class enough to know who Shehnaz Hussain is. But it's very interesting. Many key differences between fancy salon, unisex salon. It starts with the naming, right? Because fancy salon needs to have fancy name, right? You all have fancy names like Hakim's Alim, Jean-Claude Bigouin, Tresemme, and other things that Shashi Tharoor says. Like, honestly, when he made that speech where he said exasperating Faragha, I was like, yes, main kal ja raha hu udhar. Yes, get me an appointment. Unnecessarily fancy names. I think the rule that they're following, there's an unwritten rule, which is whenever they create a fancy salon, that name they give it now must get a minimum of 20 points in Scrabble. I think that is the rule they're following. There is a naming board, you take your name, go to an authority and say, sir, I have my new salon, it's called Panache, sir, Panache. Panache, 15 points, not fancy enough, bro, please leave. Next, sir, my new salon, you won't believe, it's called Zzz. Intriguing. Is that 1Z or 2Z? 2Z, sir. Well, 2 into 10, 20. Welcome to the club. Unisex salon does not really care about the name. He opens the salon, he's like, kya naam dena padega kya isko? He just asks the guy next to him, like, who is your favorite god? Ganesh. Okay, Ganesh unisex salon. It is decided. He's like, but bro, there is already Ganesh unisex salon on this road. No problem, new Ganesh unisex salon. In fact, you know what? Fuck it. Shiva's unisex salon. Literally Ganesh ka bap. Also very different when you walk into these establishments, fancy salon, unisex salon. You walk into a fancy salon, you walk in, you see that there are hair stylists, hair artists, hair couturists, hair counterculturists, hair faragos. But when you walk into unisex salon, they have none of that shit. Unisex salon has barber. Any unisex salon you go see, there are 5 barbers over there. All of their names start with J for some reason. Javed, Jaffar, Jabbar, Jahil, Jallad. I don't know why. And all of these barbers have no skill at all. Like they have, you know, most stylists, they have trained under Sapna Bhavnani. They have trained under Javed Bhabi. Barber has trained at best under banyan tree. No ability. I have been to barber for 15 years of my life. For 15 years, every time I went to him, I asked him for one haircut, the same haircut. Every time I walked out, I had a new haircut. No ability. But amazing confidence. I'll be sitting in that chair looking at him like, bro, kya kya, main nokar lag raha hai, what is this shit? Without blinking, he was like, sir, arit ekdam John lag raha, sir. John. John? Matlab kon? John Abraham? Nahi, mera dost hai John. Ghadi bechta hai Linking Road. Sip! Wah! Fucking John! Baba's friend's name also starts with J. Ridiculous. A fancy salon is a nice experience. Anytime you walk into a fancy salon, this usually happens, right? When you are at a fancy salon, at some point in your fancy salon experience, a model will walk into the salon, right? And she's done up from head to toe, lovely, wearing the Gucci dress, LV bag. She looks like she has been to 3 salons on the way to this salon. in preparation. From here, she will go to 3 more salons and then undertake her project for the day, which is to upload a selfie on Instagram. Yeah. And when the model walks in, that is when the fancy salon releases its trump card, its secret weapon, which is the gay hairstylist. He is there at every fancy salon. You just don't see him, but he's there. And when the model walks in, that is when they release him from the closet. I mean, it's not an actual closet, it's metaphorical, all right? Just clearing that up. And I saw this happening, right? While I was sitting there, getting my hair cut, model chick sat next to me, gay hairstylist approached her from behind, asked her what she wanted done. And her reply, this is verbatim, I'm giving you her reply, not changed a word, it stuck with me forever. She looked at him through the mirror and said, I want you to do a little, but it should look like a lot. I was like, yeah, aurat hai, sphinx hai, what are these riddles? What's going on? But gay hairstylist on point, he's like, what you are saying is that you want a slight trim with 2 highlights of blonde and caramel. I was like, mast fikta hai yaar. She turned back, she's like, yeah, that's exactly what I want. Mind blown. And that's when I realized the importance of the gay hairstylist, because dude, there is no straight man in the world who has the genetically wired patience to answer philosophical bullshit questions. From a woman he cannot sleep with. And in general, I don't understand this entire conversation dynamic that people have with their stylist. Like for me, I just go sit down when I go to barber or stylist. I have a simple 3-fold instruction that I give the person. I sit down on a chair, I look at him in the eye and say, side se chota, upar se lamba, baki bhagwan pe chhod. We will see. But the one key difference and the biggest difference between fancy salon and unisex salon is the use of the water spray. Because in a fancy salon, the water spray is used for artistic purposes. Yeah? To mold the hair. To tame the hair. Barber has no such agenda. Barber is playing Counter-Strike. Headshot. Pachak! And you receive that headshot and you're just completely, what is this? Where am I? Kya ho raha? What you don't know is that while this is happening, he's preparing for round 2. Akhol sale. Once more, touch a counter-terrorist wave. Listen, man, you guys have been a lot of fun. Thank you so much for listening.